Hello dear students and welcome to DAV Mohol Public School. Let's start our today's session with standard 7th mathematics. And today we will revise the unit 1, that is rational number. And under this lesson we will see today properties of rational numbers and what are the different types of number systems are there and some problems from worksheet 1 and worksheet 2.
Numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, which are used for counting, form the system of natural numbers. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the natural numbers. When we include 0 in natural number, it forms the system of whole number. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on are the whole numbers. Now, the collection of natural numbers, they are opposite numbers, means if you will put the negative sign to them with the 0, form the system of integers. So, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 are the integers. Now, part of a whole is a fraction. So, fraction is nothing but the ratio of two natural numbers, that 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, etc. These also can be represented on the number line. Now, fractions with the corresponding negative fractions and 0 constitute the system of natural numbers. So, the word rational comes from the word ratio. So, any number which can be expressed in the form of p by q means numerator and denominator, where p and q are the integers and q not equal to 0 is known as rational number. Now, these are the examples of positive rational numbers. 1 upon 5, 2 by 3, it is minus 2, minus 3, minus minus again gets cancelled. So, the number becomes positive. So, these are the positive natural numbers, rational numbers, in which both numerators and denominators have the same sign. Now, negative rational number means the rational numbers are negative. If the sign either of the numerator or denominator is negative or not same. So, 5 upon minus 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 2 by 3, 1 upon minus 4 are the examples of negative rational numbers. See here, first we will check here whether the given ratios, rational numbers are equivalent or not. For this, we have to cross multiply, take the product of 4n minus 14. 4n minus 14 equals to minus 56. And 8n minus 7, that also equals to minus 56. Both the products are equal and therefore both the rational numbers are equivalent. Now here in the second example, if you will take the cross multiplication, 5 into 24 equals to 120, but 8 into minus 15 equals to minus 120, and therefore both the products are not equal, and therefore the given rational numbers are not the equivalent rational numbers. So, in this simple way, by taking their cross multiplication, we can check whether the rational numbers are equivalent or not. Now, here we will find out the three numbers which are equivalent to 3 by 5. Simply, we have to multiply 3, that is numerator and denominator, by any non-zero integer. Here, we had taken 2, minus 3 and 5, but you can take any number so that it will form the new equivalent fractions to 3 by 5. So, first here, we will multiply 3 by 5 by 2. So, it forms 6 by 10. Then, 3 by 5 multiply by minus 3. It forms minus 9 upon minus 15. Then 3 by 5 multiply by 5, both numerator and denominator, it gives us 15 upon 25. So, these three numbers, 6 upon 10, minus 9 upon minus 15, 15 upon 25 are the three rational numbers which are equivalent to 3 by 5. Now, see here. Here we will have to find out minus 4 by 7 as a rational number, but the condition is given here, numerator is 12. Now, to get the numerator 12, we must multiply minus 4 by minus 3. Then only we will get 12. So, as we multiply minus 3, we have to multiply denominators also by minus 3. So, write minus 4 upon 7 as it is. Multiply by minus 3. It gives you 12 upon minus 21. And therefore, the required rational number is 12 upon 21. Now, the second condition is denominator must be 28. So, simply we have to multiply 7 by 4. So, numerator also we will multiply by 4. So, numerator gives you minus 4 into 4 means minus 16 and 7 into 4 means 28. and therefore the required rational number is -16/28. And the fifth example C, -21/49, we have to express as a denominator 7. So to get the 7, we have to divide 49 by 7. So in this case, both numerator and denominators we will divide by 7. So -21/7/49/7, that gives you -3/7. Hence, -3/7 is the required rational number. So in this video, students, you can solve the different questions. So here are some questions for you, so that you can revise the properties, different properties of the rational numbers. Based on this, you have to find out the equivalent rational numbers, you have to check whether the numbers are equivalent or not, and then you have to express the numbers with the numerator given conditions and the denominator with the given conditions. Thank you. Have a nice day.